Dollar Shop. I'm rolling out there right now. To go and just drop off some stuff. Sandblaster. And then parts washer. So yeah, man, we're going to touch down in about maybe 5 minutes. It's not too far from where I'm at now. And yeah, we're going to give you a little tour. It ain't big or nothing, so it ain't much of a tour, but I'm going to say y'all check it out anyway, all right? In a minute.
All right, so here we are at the new Junkyard Dog Shop. Boom. Let's see here. All right, so there it is, man. This is where we're going to be doing the future episodes and, you know, rebuilding T5s and motors and whatnot. It's very, very clean. They sealed the floors. Got a little skylight, you know, whatnot. And right over here, you know, got your power and everything. Got your restroom right there. Got a little office, you know what I'm saying? You know, a little something, something. I'm gonna put my desk right there. And my man, Edgar, gonna have his desk over here somewhere. So, boom, we see we got a couple things in here already. But yeah, there it is, man. So now that I got a shop, you guys are gonna start seeing a lot more finished products on the website, because as of now, there isn't really much on there, and it's just because of, you know, my situation. So situations change, staying on the up and up, staying on the positive, and this is what you get when you stay positive. You know what I'm saying? Keep your mind open, you know, push that negativity out, and boom, there you have it. What's going on, y'all? I'm King of the Junkyard Dog at junkyarddogs.com. So yeah, man, we're going to go ahead and finally finish up the last portion of this video with the GT40 or GT40P head upgrade for a Fox Body Mustang. But please excuse the echo that you hear in here. We're in the new shop, so it's still kind of empty. We're still moving stuff in. Remember the last vlog that I did, I was basically saying that the landlord, you know, said I had to go. The city said I had to move all my stuff, so I had to react. And rather than, you know, complaining about it, just, you know, stay positive, and here I am in the shop right now. So back to the GT40 heads, GT40P heads. So yeah, man, we took them to the machine shop, and I have a machine shop that I work with all the time. They do all my work, and they do excellent work. This is a head shop specifically. This is not Valios. This is not this company is called Arius Cylinder Head and Crankshaft Machine Shop. So they're the ones who did the crank, and they're the ones who did the they did the crankshaft, and then they do heads. So they do cranks, rods, and heads. Okay. I like this shop because they're very specific and very specialized in what they do. They're really good at doing cylinder heads, and they do them quickly. First thing they did, obviously, was a hot tank. Now what that means is, they put it in a sort of an acid wash, okay? It gets all the grease and the oil and all the crap out of the holes and whatnot, okay? So one of the first things that they did at the machine shop, after they hot tanked it and checked it for cracks, they went ahead and surfaced it. So what that means is the base of the head, or the head surface here, over time, it gets a little weird. Ford is really good about not getting whopped, but it's just a measure that I take every time I work on cylinder heads. And it tends to shrink the chamber just a little, because when you cut off a little of the surface here, the chambers get smaller. So you do get a slight bump in compression, but you also have to be careful to make sure that these valves don't open so much that it hits the piston. So the first thing they did, like I said, is they surface it, make sure it's nice and flat. They have a nice machine there, and they do an excellent job. The next thing that you do when you get your heads rebuilt would be a valve job, okay? So what they do is they remove the springs, so you can see over here, and they pull the valves out, okay? And the seats are where the valve sits in, to ensure that it's nice and closed. Now the reason why you want to do a valve job is because you want to make sure that these seal air tight. It'll make sure that your engine runs properly, okay?
So what they do is they remove the valve and they recut the seat to match this valve. Okay, so these heads have a three-angle valve job. The valve stem seals, as you can see, we have these blue valve stem seals that are brand new. Those stop oil from leaving the spring valley here and going down into the chamber through the valve stem, okay? That's a very, very important thing. Sometimes you might find that your engine is burning oil, and you will find that sometimes it's just these seals that are bad. So we make sure that we change those every time we work on the cylinder heads. One big issue that you'll find with GT40 and GT40P heads are the stock springs, okay? These ones checked out okay, okay? One thing about Explorers is that they never tend to really rev high. Like I said in a much earlier video, it's driven by some soccer mom or something, you know? She's not dipping out at 5,500 RPM very often, okay? So the springs are okay, but if you're gonna be running anything more than a stock cam, you have to change these springs. This is just good for a guy who's got, like, you know, stock cam, just wants a little bit more oomph, and wants to just bolt on some power really quick, perfect. But if you do want to get into the arena of starting to run a bigger cam or whatnot, you have to change these springs. Especially on the GT40P heads, because the springs on those are so weak, they can't even handle a stock cam, okay? So make sure that you change the springs out. So yeah, we put in new freeze plugs. And the reason why we do this is because the original freeze plugs are steel. Problems with that is they rust out and they start throwing rust around in the motor, and you don't want that. Brass lasts a whole lot longer. Actually, it most likely will outlive the life of the motor. So this is a great upgrade for just stock heads, some brass freeze plugs. If you don't put brass in there and you're trying to save like $1.50 per freeze plug, you probably shouldn't be messing with motors or heads, because it's such a cheap thing to do, and it makes a huge difference in the quality of your coolant. It makes a big difference in the longevity of you know, the head, and not causing any leaks here. Because imagine, this is against the firewall. The firewall's like here. So imagine this thing starts leaking. What a pain, okay? So you just go ahead and take care of it while they're out. All right, and there you have it. So GT40 cylinder heads, that's the swap. I will be showing you guys how to install heads on a later episode, but right now I just wanted you guys to see the process of what happens with Junkyard Dawgs when we get a set of heads and we go through them from the junkyard all the way to the finished product.
So how you feel, man? You get some GT40s.
I'm happy, man. We're gonna get this big, heavy Luxo boat here moving.
He's running with the Lincoln LSC, man. This is hard right here, man. Don't sleep on the LSC, man. Well, thank you for messing with the dog, man. I really appreciate it, dog.
Thank you, Tony.
All right, you got it.
So, yeah, man, just stay positive. Keep doing your things out there, guys. The best bang for your buck is to go out there and find some yourself. I showed you guys how to identify them, how to pull them, and how you should be having them rebuilt, okay? So, yeah. Here we go, man. Junkyard Dawgs!